So this is the simplest case. And I can kind of demonstrate it to you in a real circuit. So I took some time setting this up. Let's hope it works this time. So I have my camera. So let me actually build the real circuits that we are calculating. Oops. Real circuits that we are calculating numbers for there. And let's see if the signal, what we are deriving as answers actually happen, you know, experimentally. So I worked out some of the values that would work out. So let's see. So I'm going to build an RC circuit. Here's my resistor, capacitor. This is a 10 microfarad capacitor, not that the, wait. Okay, 10 microfarad capacitor, and this is a 1 kilo ohm resistor. And this is RC circuit, right? And I'm going to connect from one end to the other. So what I'm supposed to do is charge up this capacitor, and then at time equals zero, just to connect this, short this so that you have a circuit, right? I can't really do it manually. So the way I'm going to do is I'm going to do it with a function generator. So function generator will be, connected to these two ends. Ground here, and the positive voltage here. So when I, for some amount of time, there's going to be current flowing, charging up this capacitor. And at some time that I'm going to call time equals zero, the voltage of the function generator will go to zero. That makes the function generator behave like a simple wire. So at that time is when all of this starts. Okay, so let's try that. So I connected the function generator. Let me turn on. Is the time scale right? I'm at too high a frequency, probably. Okay, this is about right. I think this is about right. So right now, what this oscilloscope is showing is the output of the function generator. And I have set things up so that, so that the ground, there's just enough DC offset. So this is the position of the ground, 0 volt. And I put in some amount of DC offset on the function generator so that there's some period of time when the function generator is outputting 0 volts. And I have it triggered on a downward slope so that there are stuff happening to the left of what you are seeing. Imagine moving this over by half a cycle, that's what you are seeing there. All right, so let's turn on B, A, B, and connect this to the, I want to measure the amount of charge on the capacitor. So I guess I can show this on the camera. So what I'm going to do is, the ground will connect itself, so I'm not going to really worry about it. I'm going to connect this end to this other side of the capacitor. That'll measure the voltage across the capacitor, and that'll be proportional to the amount of charge on the capacitor. So let me connect that there. And all right, I have to go slower. So it doesn't look like exponential right now because I need to go slower. All right. Does that look like an exponential? Yeah. So that's what this result was predicting, that at this moment of time, right here, is where, this is where t equals zero, and what the oscilloscope is graphing, voltage drop across the capacitor, this is proportional to Q of t, or which is proportional to e to the minus t over RC. And you guys looked at the time constant. This RC, this is what we call time constant. And you looked at it a little bit in the lab. For those of you who might not have gotten that far, here's one meaning of time constant tau that we can assign to. So when time is equal to tau, then this factor becomes e to the minus t over rc becomes e to the minus 1. Or in terms of charge, your q of t would become q naught divided by e. This is approximately equal to q naught divided by 3. E is like 2.7 something. So if you're trying to figure out time constant on this graph, then what you do is, all right, you look at how much the voltage falls to 1/3, or falls by 2/3. So it's starting at 1, 2, 3 and a little bit more division. Let me actually make it 3 divisions. When it's exactly 3 divisions, then where it crosses here, this is supposed to be, so this amount of time here, that's supposed to be the time constant. Let's see if it is. I was telling you what the values of the resistor and the capacitor were. The capacitor, let me double check it, is 10 microfarad. So here I have R equals 1 kilo ohm, and the capacitance of 10 microfarad, meaning my time constant tau is 10 to the 3 ohm times, let me make myself wrong. Tau is equal to 10 to the 3 ohm times 10 microfarad will be 10 times 10 to the minus 6 farad, or 10 to minus 5 farad. I'm just going to trust my SI unit system and believe that ohm times farad is going to be seconds. You can do it on your own if you don't trust it. So the time constant here should be 10 to the minus 2 seconds. So this better be about 10 milliseconds. So that looks like about one division. I hope I'm on 10 milliseconds per division scale. I'm on 10 milliseconds per division scale, in case you don't believe. Yeah. Good. So, everything agrees here.